Father, real quick,
for the essence of time, and we'll just miss a Brown Roman. I'll wait. For the essence of time, we'll get started. We shouldn't take, shouldn't be here for about 15 minutes, if that. Okay. We have a picture right here. I would like for us to use one word to describe these fans. Use one word. What's the word that comes to mind to describe these fans?
Losers.
Okay, losers.
Excited.
Crazy. Dedicated, crazy.
Engaged.
Passionate, engaged.
They're still losers.
They're passionate. Good. Now, these are some of the qualities that educators that we have, and that's why we do what we do, because we're passionate about helping kids. We're fanatical at times about seeing growth. Sometimes we're even crazy when we look at data, and we still have long ways to go and the gaps close in on. Next slide, please. We have a little introduction activity. Just to kind of spice things up a bit so people won't be just staring at their phones and stuff like that and texting, and that's fine. So we have a little note card. Please keep the note cards closed. Do not open them. Do not open them yet. Do not open them.
All right, who's going to act like a regular student in the
note? Do not open the card yet. Now, I'm going to explain everything to us. I'm going to explain the activity. It's going to take approximately 2 minutes. Have a seat. Do not open your note card. And
yes, sir.
What we're going to do, after we're going to all open our note cards on my command. After we open our note card, we're going to close it back up and put it in our pocket. So read the note card, put it in our pocket. And then, so that's what I need everyone to do now. Open your note cards, read it. Jones, and put it back in your pocket. Remember what that note card says. So now what we're going to do, everyone's going to stand up. And what we're going to do is, we're going to trust each other. We're going to, for the next 30 seconds, everyone is just going to close their eyes. We're going to close their eyes, and we're only going to, the only thing we can say is the sound of that note card that we have. For the next 30 seconds, and we want to link up with the other partners. Okay? So we're going to use the sound.
So someone in this room is the same thing as me.
Correct. Correct.
Oh, so just one other person.
No. It's a group. It's 12 of us, so it'll be about 4
and 4.
We're
doing this with our eyes closed.
Yes, sir.
In the hope that we don't fall and break our
heads. We will not. Everybody got it?
Sure.
Okay, close your eyes. And only for 60 seconds, okay? Only for 60 seconds. Close your eyes. Excuse me? Only the sound, yes. 60 seconds. Begin. Talking or being demonstrative or loud to listening, being a little bit more passive. Go ahead. That's the same thing with our communication. It's not a one-way street. Is communication a one-way street, or is it a dividing lane that goes both ways? It obviously goes both ways. And that's important because we're communicating with not only adults, but we're communicating with students as well, and that's why we're doing this. So we have goals and we have objectives that we want our students to accomplish, and our students, they have needs that they feel are equally as important as ours as well. And that's what brings us to the next point, which is March Madness, okay? We need to have just fanatical effort and fanatical sense of urgency for the rest of the school year in order to continue to see growth and to build upon what we've been doing. Now, the next slide. This PBIS plan, grade level plan, that's just the name we gave it, March Madness PBIS plan. We want to just be positive for the behavior so then the students can earn extra rewards, okay? And what we're going to focus on, the purpose of it, purpose of March Madness PBIS plan is to strategize new ways of monitoring positive and negative behavior, but it's really just positive, and behavior for academic practices. We want to minimize distractions in the classroom so that we can optimize the amount of learning that's taking place and actual seat time. Additionally, we will reward behaviors that are positively demonstrated among the grade level at the end of each week. So this is something that's not going to be tedious, but the kids, they want more free time, recess, things of that nature. Well, they're going to be able to earn it based through these practices. Data collection, this is going to be very simple. We'll show you the spreadsheet. The students for each academic student data will be tracked by each teacher. So each teacher will have a sheet that has just 8 boxes on Monday and 5 throughout the rest of the week. And we're going to track homeroom. They just get a check, each classes, and then transitions. Each teacher will receive a copy and post in the classroom. It was a simple checklist on a matrix cell that we'll show you in a second. Thursday at 2:15, when we're meeting in our departments, the groups will bring your data sheet to your group meeting. They'll be collected and tallied up, and then we'll see if the students meet their goals. If they meet their goals, then that will be announced either on announcements Thursday afternoon or Friday morning, whichever Ms. Barber sees fit. Behaviors monitor. These are behaviors that we discuss as a target or problem behaviors in homeroom. So this is the sections where we will be, that you see on your sheet. We'll monitor homeroom, advisement, class, Whitmer study skills, and transitions. Proper use of electronics. And we're stating this in a positive way because we all know that we want to be positive. So all this is no cell phones. Proper use of electronics. Book bags put away is a safety issue. So that's in homeroom. They'll get a check. They can earn a check if no one has their phone out, if no one has their book leaving their homeroom at the end of homeroom with their book bags, and if they're only in the hallway with permission. So that's to cut down on the lingering. If they don't have a purpose or permission to be in the hallway, they should be in our classrooms. So that's what the homeroom can earn a check for that, for those behaviors. And it's all or nothing. So if one person has a cell phone out, then they miss their check for that particular day. And the hope is for self-policing. So the students will see somebody try to check the time. Hey, put your phone up, no, just wait. That sort of deal. Or they ask for permission. Advisement. Materials, make sure they're prepared. So we're not always passing out paper, or if we do have paper, it's their responsibility to get it and be prepared, and then just grade an effort. Are they sitting up? Are they actively engaged and participating? Simple, easy enough. Class, proper use of electronics. Materials, are they prepared? Homework is included in that as well. On task, appropriate conversations. So that's a cut down on the excessive talking. That's all the on-task, appropriate conversations. That's going to be the volume and the timing of it. So they're not talking while teachers are talking, et cetera, et cetera, to address the excessive talking. Wicker study skills, lunch. Doing Wicker study skills, are they putting forth effort? Are they engaged in the lesson? Are they participating? And the transition to lunch, are they single, silent, straight? Transition, single, silent, straight as well. They'll get a check for that for each transition. Go ahead, Johnson. And we have the goal is to ensure.
No, hold on. Sorry, I skipped the slide.
This is what the matrix will look like. So each teacher will just have one of these, and you just write a check. The homeroom, if your students were in the homeroom and not in the hallway without permission, then they'll have a check by that advisement. If they had effort and materials and advisement, they'll get a check. In class, if they were on task with their or have appropriate conversations, no electronics, and prepare, then they'll get a check for that. If they did not, then they'll get an X. They will not receive a check. So that is what the check sheet, the matrix will look like, and we just put a check or X. Yes, sir?
With the way we're doing this, you said they're announcing it Thursday afternoon or Friday morning.
Yes, sir.
Now, are the rewards they're getting for that week going to be that Friday of that week or the following Friday?
It will be that Friday.
So are we going to run from previous Friday to Thursday since there's a Friday call?
We will do that. We will run from Friday. That week will start from Friday to Thursday.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
That's what I want you to
do. Okay. And we have the flexibility because we'll just take up sheets on Thursday. So say Johnson. We should, that's our goal, obviously, to make sure that the students are engaged, okay? We want to make sure they're engaged, and we're seeing an increase in positive behavior and a decrease in negative behavior. The next slide. And the rollout, to answer to your questions, Owen, we'll roll this plan out. We'll start it on Wednesday, and the students will be introduced to it on Tuesday at the town hall. So essentially, they will have Wednesday and Thursday to earn their Friday, free Friday, which would be a recess, and they can sit wherever they would like to at lunchtime for more socializing and things of that nature. And they will understand that they need to meet 80% or get 80% of all checks available. So that 80% would just be based off of Wednesday and Thursday.
Now, are we going to do this where it's 80% for the whole hall?
80% per grade level, because per team it will be too difficult because we don't sit in teams at lunch and say this team can sit where they want, this team has recess, things of that nature, and classes change and things, and so it's a little more difficult. Does that make sense?
No, that's fine. I was just curious how we're doing it. No, that's fine. I was just curious how we're doing it. If we're doing it as 80% of the grade levels have gotten their checks in order for them to get their free Friday.
Correct. Okay. Correct. Nothing great was ever achieved without enthusiasm. It's important as we roll this out to the kids that we're selling them a positive, enthusiastic approach of, hey, we're trying to work with you. Come on, you all can do this, and then that way you can earn a little more freedom and flexibility. And who knows, we may even throw in a pizza party at the end if we get 3 out of 4 weeks or something like that as well. We'll double check with Ms. Barber as far as the budgets are concerned to give them a bigger prize so that we have small goals and a larger goal as well, but in hopes of them having more focus time and being more prepared in the class.